Well, welcome to the news for this, the 21st week of 2021. I'm Matt Miller, and this is Trekzone. Well, supporting Trekzone is easy, fast and fun. Get the details at thetrekzone.com/support. As well as liking this video and subscribing on YouTube, you should ring the bell to get our latest eps straight to your notifications. If you're listening to podcasts, find us on your favourite app, subscribe, and that'll mean you'll get the latest content downloaded to your device. Now, onto the news. Mike McMahan has been doing the rounds to drum up media attention for the Blu-ray release of Lower Decks Season 1 and the upcoming second season. Speaking to Screen Rant, the showrunner offered some details of stories they'll be following, including Rutherford's memory issues, Mariner and her mum working together, the Packleds being a real threat, Tendi worried about her friends not remembering her from the first season, and what does that mean for their friendship? Plus, Boimler on the Titan, McMahan noting that the Titan is a whole different beast, and part of what they'll be tracking is what does that mean for the character? How does he fit in with the new group over there without the cohort that came together across the premiere season? How is he experiencing it, and how are our other Lower Deckers experiencing him not being there? Season 2 premieres on August 12, with the series already renewed for a third beyond that. The next season of Star Trek Online kicked off this week. Mary Chifo, Rekha Sharma, Robert O'Reilly and J.G. Hertzler are all back lending their voices to the characters they made famous on live-action Star Trek. The new season, called House United, dropped for PC on May 25, allowing players to prove their worth before building an army and heading to Kronos for the final battle. PS4 and Xbox One players will have to wait until August 3, though. Perfect World's press release says players will have two new chapters following Klingon content, along with an event called Only Kronos Endures, a task force operation called Remain Klingon, and three new patrols. Hypersonix have demonstrated the capabilities of their green hydrogen-powered Spartan Scramjet engine. Accelerating from Mark 5 to Mark 10, in the Shock Tunnel testing facility of the University of Queensland, the Scramjet engine has demonstrated it can accelerate up to 10 times the speed of sound in real-life flight conditions. With the recent announcement of a collaboration with Boeing to develop a proof-of-concept reusable hypersonic launch vehicle, the Brisbane and Sydney-based startup have conducted 111 ground-firing tests at the UQ facility. The Spartan is part of a three-stage system developed to launch satellites into low Earth orbit. The first stage, a rocket, will ensure the Scramjet reaches its minimum operating speed around Mach 5. The Scramjet will then kick in and accelerate up to Mach 12, where another rocket will take over, taking the payload into its final location. Testing hypersonic vehicles is complex, and while computer modelling can be used, these models need to be verified in flight conditions. The University of Queensland's free piston shock tunnel has been designed to do just that. And I'll be chatting with Michael Smart, the head of R&D and co-founder of Hypersonix Launch Systems, this week as part of a Talk in Science triple treat. Queensland is one step closer to a rocket launch site after the state government confirmed it will support a Gilmour Space push to develop a site in Abbot Point. Located in the Bowen region of the second biggest Australian state, Abbot Point has long been touted as the preferred launch location, with a report tabled late last year confirming its suitability. Deputy Premier and Minister for State Development Stephen Miles said growing our space industry in Queensland will add billions to the economy and create thousands of local jobs. That's why they are committed to development of the launch infrastructure. The site at Abbot Point has a number of strategic benefits too, not the least of which the ability to launch over water, as it's preferred to launching them there over uninhabited areas. The site also has an advantage of being close to the equator, 19 degrees latitude in fact, where the rotation of the Earth will assist with the launch. Gilmour Space are also looking at a proposed launch site in South Australia for complementary polar orbits in line with their vision to achieve all orbits, all planets. Australia is currently developing a number of commercial launch sites, with Equatorial Launch's Arnhem Space Centre in the Northern Territory and the Southern Launch-operated Whalers Way site, while the latter also currently operates suborbital launches from the Cunibert Test Range. Gilmour Space CEO Adam Gilmour said of this announcement that he doesn't see a reason why Australia can't be demonstrating key sovereign space capability as early as next year. Well, what a week on Trekzone. We recapped Talking Treks, Faith of the Heart, got the news from Science and Space from Dr. Brad, went live for the total lunar eclipse on Wednesday, and caught up on that time when we went inside Northrop Grumman, met the 8-bit guy, and spoke to Doug Drexler about the crazy workloads on Star Trek in the 90s. And coming up this week, we'll be recapping the Talking Trek journey through the movies, getting a news hit with Dr. Brad, kicking off a triple treat of Talking Science. Dr. Sarah Pierce will be here Wednesday to discuss her new posting at the Square Kilometer Array. And Michael Smart sits down with us to chat about his company's new Scramjet engine, as I mentioned just before. Plus, we'll flash back to that time when we met Jeffrey Combs and Alice Cridge. Don't miss a moment. Subscribe and ring the bell on our YouTube channel. Subscribe to our podcast feed in your favorite podcasting app and sign up for the mailing list on the website. Of course, that's trekzone.org. Leave a comment on YouTube too. Let's chat about the stories of this week. But for now, and as always, I'm Matt Miller for Trekzone.
Keep up to date with Twitter. Catch new podcasts daily on YouTube. Plus, we're beaming to your favorite podcast app 5 days a week. Just search for Trekzone and subscribe.